Good afternoon. Welcome to this pre-ISA conference session hosted by Food Nutrition Security Cloud. My name's Sian Astley. I'm the communications manager for the project. I work for URFO, which is a non-profit association based in Brussels. And so that we can keep to time, I'm going to give you a very brief introduction while people are still coming in, a little bit of housekeeping. Hello and welcome. Really pleased to see you all here. For those that can't make it, we will be putting the talks onto the website, which is why this session has been recorded, but we won't include the Q&A when it comes to what we put on the web. Some speakers will be joining us later because they have other appointments during the day. I don't know about anyone else, but I'm sure I'm having more meetings since lockdown than I ever had face to face. I would ask that you keep yourself muted and your camera off during the talks, simply to preserve broadband and make sure that everybody has a good signal. But when you ask a question, then please put your camera on and your microphone so that we can see who we're talking to. I won't take questions and answers, and that's simply because I suspect that many of the questions you might have for me will be answered by subsequent speakers. If you really do have a pressing question for me at the end, then I can answer those for you then. But at the moment, I'd like to focus on our first results coming out of FNS Cloud. So, what is FNS Cloud? FNS Cloud is a project that's been funded by Horizon 2020, and its vision really is to help to overcome the fragmentation that currently exists. There is a great deal of data around food that exists in Europe and indeed globally, but focusing just on Europe, there is a lot of data out there as well as knowledge and tools. But one of the problems is that it's very fragmented, both in terms of the spoken language that it's in terms of the design and structure of the studies that it's been developed in, how it's made accessible, if indeed it is made accessible. There are still far too many bits of data that are sitting on people's computers or on servers, and others don't have access to this very valuable resource. And access, when it is achievable, is not even. So for many, it's not achievable to get access to the data because it's costly or there's some other inhibition in terms of accessing it. So the vision is that we overcome that fragmentation and that we make food, nutrition, and security data fairer. So that's more findable, more accessible, more interoperable, and more reusable. And that will reduce the knowledge gaps that we have. It will facilitate better research and exploitation, ultimately helping to inform policy and deliver more sustainable diets to European citizens. Our mission is to implement and test the cloud itself via the use cases, many of which you're going to hear about today, and also the demonstrators, of which our last talk from Paul Finglas, the scientific coordinator of FNS Cloud, will talk about. But that's very much looking towards the future. At the moment, we're focused on the use cases because they're the ones that are generating the outputs. To develop and integrate and test the tools and services that will help FNS researchers to exploit these data when they are more findable, and then to harmonize and standardize FNS data, and that's in terms of sources, formats, and languages, and that's both spoken but also machine languages, because a lot of this could be done better, at least on a semi-automated basis, if not on a fully automated basis. And then it's about external services, so that might be apps to facilitate integration and interoperability. And it's to engage you, the FNS user communities, particularly FNS researchers, to improve cooperation, to reduce barriers, and to promote innovation and exploitation. And then also to develop governance and business models in parallel with the wider European Open Science Cloud user community, so that we can make this entity sustainable, probably not commercial, but at least sustainable to ensure that once we've made that data fairer, that it continues to be accessible and reusable. So this is a quite a complicated slide, and it's not my intention that you understand all of it. It shows the different supplies of information coming in around food. The bit we're interested in is in the middle, in terms of the food supply chains, the food environment, consumer behavior, actual diet choices, and then the nutritional health outcomes, but also the social, economic, and environmental impact of the some of the decisions that we make. The project itself, there are nine work packages. The ninth deals entirely with the ethics to related to the studies that are ongoing, particularly in work package four. The other eight deal with a number of other aspects: the technical development of the cloud, the development of tools and services, the use cases, which we'll talk about a bit more in a minute, the demonstrators, and also dissemination, communication, and the community engagement, education, training, and support, and then governance and sustainability. And you can see there who the work package leaders are for each of those work packages. We have 35 beneficiaries, so it's quite a large project. There are 11 EU member states, the UK, Serbia, and Switzerland. And there are research organizations, including universities, but there are also for-profit and non-profit SMEs and associations. And we are a very mixed bag of people with different specialities. So we have IT specialists, FNS researchers, social scientists, lawyers, science communicators, and multiplier organizations like indeed Izeki, but also EFOST and ILSI Europe. And this is about understanding the landscape that we're working in and how FNS Cloud fits in that. On the left-hand side of the slide, you'll see a number of logos. These were just picked because I happen to have them on my hard disk. They're not by any means a comprehensive description of the number of projects that the European Union has funded around food. They're just some examples. And there are hundreds of projects that have generated data, tools, or indeed services that could potentially feed into FNS Cloud. And indeed, from FNS Cloud, feeding out to other resources such as the EFRI research infrastructures, and that includes where BBMRI, Elixir, and other examples, but also emerging infrastructures such as Metro Food. And potential infrastructures such as the food, nutrition, and health research infrastructure, and of course, indeed, the European Open Science Cloud, which is in the process of developing. And indeed, they can feed back data to FNS Cloud. So, this is a very dynamic landscape with information coming in and out and back in again. In terms of the global outlook, FNS Cloud fits in the middle. Where you've got other already referred to clouds and the S3 research infrastructures, you've got any number of networks. That again is not comprehensive, it's just some examples that I've chosen. Past projects, global agencies and EU agencies such as FAO, EFSA, and JPI, and also indeed international projects such as GloboDiet. And they feed everything from information around primary production, and we'll hear a little bit more about that from Claudio very shortly, right through to health. And we can start to think about how we would have more sustainable, healthier diets. So, implementation, one of those areas of implementation is the nine use cases and the field labs, which are focusing on making existing and emerging FNS data fairer. And generating proof of principle data when none has existed previously, and then testing the actual cloud infrastructure and the tools and services. And those will then feed into the demonstrators, which will be tested with the user community. So if you continue to watch this space, we might be looking to you to come and test those demonstrators and give us some feedback. To address the limitations and the implementation of improvements, and then to analyze the technology readiness level, in other words, how usable they are, what more work needs to be done, and how well they perform. Now, in terms of the use cases in the field trials, as I said, the use cases are focusing on existing data, and they are helping to develop a number of activity areas. So, food traceability and metrology, search engine, reformulation tools, risk assessment, consumer behavior and lifestyle against food intake, And then also around the areas of lifestyle and non-communicable diseases cohorts, and that's around risk and potential benefits related to diet. And that's mostly what you're going to hear about today, but there are some talks as well about some of our emerging ones from the field trials, and they are novel data intake and behavioral tools, the family meal planning, healthy diets with a healthy microbiome, and the alert classification system for food drug diet interactions. The demonstrators themselves start to collect all of that information coming in from the user cases and the field trials, with knowledge and tools and services to start to actually answer specific research questions. And the demonstrator one focuses on traceability, metrology, labeling, reformulation, and risk benefit. The second demonstrator focuses on intake behavior, purchase preparation and consumption of foods, and also the composition of those foods. And then the de third demonstrator on NCDs, and the microbiome, and particularly healthy diets, healthy microbiome, risk for diabetes, and then also food drug interactions. I'm not going to tell you much more about the user cases or indeed the field trials and the demonstrators because that will come out in subsequent talks. However, FNS Cloud is also charged with evening up the playing field for FNS researchers, and part of that is delivering education, training, and support to enhance skills and build confidence. There is an awareness that researchers are not confident using IT tools to interrogate and make conclusions from large data sets. And so FNS Cloud is also delivering a train the trainer program, focusing on skills that FNS researchers need. And those aren't just scientific, they're also soft skills, which most of us have learnt on the job. And honestly, it would be so much better if we could learn them sooner and do them better. We're also creating a community of practice, My FNS Cloud, and the aim there is to allow us to interact more readily and to share our knowledge and skills, to offer those up for other researchers, and to help, if you like, make the ability to use that data fairer, not just the access to the data, but to be able to use it. We're also looking at work-based learning, so mentoring schemes to support young researchers, young in their career rather than young in age, to improve their professional practice and build confidence. And that again is supported by an annual conference and social media. I am hoping that one day we might not have to stare at screens and we can actually start to meet each other face to face again, for that annual conference. So the expected impacts are improved professional skills and competencies, more interaction, greater emphasis on the user communities and user-centered research outputs, sustainability, and also from that, global employment opportunities and improved FNS science. And then if we see uptake of the recommendations that come out of the project, then we would hope to see a measurable increase in FNS data being much more fairer, facilitation of dialogue and exchange amongst those user communities, more frequent exchange with stakeholders, be that policymakers or be that citizens, improved health in older adults, particularly with the emphasis on quality of life, and a more sustainable food chain. Please excuse the Cocker Spaniel behind me. And then this is just the last slide on the summarizing the outputs of FNS Cloud, some of which you're going to hear about today. So that's my talk. It's a very quick skip through FNS Cloud and what we're doing.